Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, your guide to green and clean beauty. And I'm back today with another Q&A. So I'm going to be answering all your questions. That's pretty much it. So if you wanna hear more, then stick around and let's get into it.
Heads up, if you're going from toxic to non-toxic and have no clue where to start, check out my free green beauty guide back on the website. It's the one pager I wish I had when I first started out. In the meantime, don't forget to like this video and make sure you subscribe so you never miss another one.
Okay, so first question is from Mel, and she said, hey Britt.
Hey Mel.
Wanted to know if you could share this product out, and she is referring to the Bamboo Blur from 100% Pure Tinted Moisturizer. I think that you could put it with a primer or another SPF product, like I have the Kula right here in front of me. It's kind of more of a whipped, like lighter weight moisturizer. Pump a little bit of the Bamboo Blur on there and then use a sponge. That would sheer it out a little bit. I don't think it's one of those where you can put the moisturizer on and then put it on top and it sheers. I think you have to either put it together with the product beforehand or do the sponge to really kind of lift it up a little bit and keep kind of working with it that way. Let me know if you try that and how it goes. Good question. I'm actually wearing this right now and I'm wearing it over a sunscreen, which is kind of like a tinted moisturizer. I used a kabuki brush to blend it in. It buffs it out. I wouldn't say it shears it out. I just think it buffs it out. It lifts a little bit of the product so you're not seeing it settle as much. I don't know if that's helpful, but I just wanted you to know that. Oh, okay, so somebody named SM asked me in the best under, 25 and under, asked me what I was wearing. I was wearing a combination of the RMS Sacred Lip Shine with the Coquette from Vapor. Those two are just like really vibrant coral raspberry colors. I combined them and then, you know, you ended up with that look. So I'll put a link to the video if you guys wanna see what it looked like, but now you know. I always combine lip stuff. Like I always combine lip stuff. Summer Bell, first of all, love your name. Have you ever tried the Elate Beauty Brow Balm? I have not yet. Elate is a brand that I'm really looking into heavily, will probably be on my next shopping haul because of their packaging, their sustainability, the way that they do it is kind of like light years beyond what a lot of people are doing in the industry. So I will look at the brow balm. I'm kind of looking at their bronzer and then they have these powders as well, like luminizing powders. So if anybody else has other Elate recommendations, let me know because I think I'm going to be purchasing them next time around. Oh my goodness. Fran, you asked the best question. So she asked, how would you compare the Inika BB cream to the Inika foundation? Right, so great question. I actually created a video for it and it is going to be posted probably by the time I put this Q&A up, if not like right after it. So I felt like it needed a full video there and then I put a comparison of applications so you can see one applying versus the other and kind of four main differentiating points between the two just to help you figure out what you can buy, what's best for you, what's best for your lifestyle. So that is coming soon. Thank you for asking this question. Totally inspired that video. Okay, somebody else said, thanks for the Fit Glow recommendation for the mascara. Really loving it. I do lightly swipe another mascara on top to prevent some of the particles from falling in on my face later that day. So this is interesting. So I actually took this and I tried this myself. The Fit Glow mascara does have little fibers or particles like this person was saying. And I'm sure that there's a little bit of flaking that happens. I don't see much of it when I use a primer. I don't always use a primer. There. I don't know. I don't see much of it. Still, I have heard this before. So I wanted to share this comment with you because I tried the Fit Glow and then it just recently in a Get Ready With Me, I applied the Inika on top, which is just a smoother formula. And it really sort of locked it in, I think. And it added a little bit more drama. So this is brilliant. I've always combined lip products. I've never combined mascaras. And now like, I think that's all I'm gonna be doing. Like, it's just gonna be a lot of mascara combinations. It's more of a dramatic look. If you're looking for something lighter and more natural and a little bit more like feathery is what I like to call it. Don't know why, just do. The Hint mascara is really good at that. I have a whole video speaking to all the mascaras. So search the main page on the channel for mascara. You will see it. But love, love, love this tip. Thank you for sending it. Carla, good question. She asks, I thought that using titanium dioxide in powder form, such as bronzers and powder foundation, was toxic because it can be inhaled. What do you think? Okay, great question. Thank you so much for asking it. At the end of the day, it's not about what I think. It's about what information I find. So So let me just put that out there. I did look online. I'm on my phone right now. Sorry, guys. And I looked up titanium dioxide. You can look it up on EWG.org, their Skin Deep database. It has a 1 to 3, and in here, it goes through everything. It says, like, okay, here's the overall hazard. Is there any information backing it up? It says that it is a possible human carcinogen only for inhalation and products that may be aerosolized, airborne. Limited evidence of carcinogenicity, I can speak, only for products that may be aerosolized, airborne. Limited evidence again. At the end of the day, this is the perfect illustration of why I developed the rule of three, which again is a loose rule. It is personal, but it is like your North Star if you want to use it. You do not have to use it. I like to use it because if there's something on EWG that's a 3 or below, for me personally right now, I'm okay using it. Titanium dioxide is not a no-go for me yet. So I'm not personally concerned about it, but that's just me. So I suggest you do your research. I'll put a link to the Skin Deep database in this video so you can look at it on your own. And people have different situations in different circumstances, like immune systems could be compromised and they can't even look at titanium dioxide. There are a lot of words like possible, potential, expected to be, which is the pain in the butt about this whole thing because no one's giving you a straight answer, which is why I can't give you a straight answer. Like, I wish I could go to a lab right now and tell you yes or no on this. And if you don't want to deal with being on the fence, by the way, then just avoid it. That's the best thing you can do. That's my spiel. Really, at the end of the day, just keep asking questions. Oh, also, it's important to know the percentage, and I say this on the scorecard. So if you are concerned about a product having titanium dioxide, then by all means, ask the brand about it. Percentage matters, and they usually don't post that on the actual ingredients list or the product packaging. So keep that in mind. Oh, okay, so Lils, hey Lils, asked, can you do a video on products that are clean from conventional brands? When I say conventional brands, I'm thinking Fenty, thinking NARS, thinking Bobbi Brown, you know, all those biggies that you would find in Sephora. So I'm not really sure. I think we're defining conventional a little bit different. In my mind, when I say conventional, I mean those that haven't really taken the big steps to create or source cleaner ingredients. So really, I don't know of many conventional brands from what I've used. Like all the stuff that I used to use, which was, again, using the word conventional with my air quotes, that had a lot of crap in it. So I don't really use any. And if you have one in particular that you know about, go to the Think Dirty app, go to the Healthy Living app from EWG, and you can look by product and see what's clean and what isn't. For your standards. Naomi, 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 Naomi. Nunu, Nana. I don't know. Thank you for asking your question. Sorry, I just went crazy with your name. Have you tried their baked bronzer? She's referring to Inigo Organic. I can't decide if I should try their baked bronzer or Well People Bio baked bronzer. So I haven't tried their bronzer yet. I am about to get it. I love the Well People Bio baked bronzer. It is a warmer color. I have a full review on that. And some people have also said that if they have oilier skin, it oxidizes a little bit orange on them. I haven't had that problem and I have combination skin, but I'm just putting the information out there for you. But I have a full review for Well People. I will soon have a full review for Inika's baked bronzer because it's like right there in a box. I'm about to do an unboxing, so more to come. Okay, and final kind of more of a comment slash question. This is fantastic. I just saw an IG post saying that RDF, Ritual Defea, is reformulating many, possibly all of their products to remove phenoxyethanol. Wonder if you could get your product replaced if you write to them. That's a great question. I'm going to ask them that question. Still, I wonder if they're gonna recycle it because now, you know, sustainability and all that. So I will ask them that question. Thank you for calling that out. And I did check with them. They are reformulating. What I found through them, this was fun, that their ingredients list on one site was totally different than an ingredients list on the other site, which is not their fault. The other retailers who need to kind of stay on top of these things, but that just goes to show you how often formulas change. It just kind of sucks because you have to go back to the brand page sometimes if you want the most up-to-date formula information. One added layer, you guys, I know. So I'm trying to keep track of things and review them for you to prevent any additional confusion. But thank you so much for this call out. I will check it out and I will email the brand, see what they say. And then maybe I'll post a follow up on here or on my IG stories to report back. And that's it. Those are the questions for this week. Thank you so much for sending your comments and your questions over on YouTube. Keep your comments and questions coming. I love them and they help me. They inspire me and I am learning right along with you. And there's just like this magical thing happening. What I mean? I appreciate it and I appreciate you. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you all right back here real soon. Until then, bye.